Welcome back, Ashen Ones, to our fourth episode of the Complete Guide Dark Souls 3. Right here, I'm just basically showing you where you can see how much hollowing you have. And I'm just going to complete his quest, right, or quest line here to give me the five extra free levels. And once I'm done with that, I'm going to show you where you can go within the Firelink Shrine to actually kill yourself, so you don't have to go somewhere else and then come back to him. Now you do need to get it up to 16 deaths, or 16 hollowing, I guess. Now the hollowings will stack if you get more than one dark sign or sigil. So if you I think it's if you kill yourself three times, you can actually go back to him, get another dark sigil, so you'll have two, and then it will start stacking by two, so you'll go next time you die to five and then seven, stuff like that. I think I actually went up to six and then just got the second one and then went up that way instead. So we're just coming back up here to grab the souls because there should be a new NPC down here. And we're going to go talk to her real quick and grab the Londor Braille Tome. Don't give this tome to Irene, your miracle merchant. We're actually going to give it to someone else later on in the game. That way it doesn't affect her storyline. Now we're actually just gonna start with the actual gameplay footage of the Road of Sacrifice. So let's head there now and start showing you how to get all the items and defeat all the enemies. Alright, so as you can see, we actually came to this bonfire earlier after beating that ice warrior monster guy that we had him go down the elevator. So these enemies aren't too bad. They will basically transform, sprouting wings whenever you get close to them. And they don't attack during that animation, but you can attack them. So you can actually kill them before they finish that animation, which makes it a really easy to actually take these guys out. So there's another one. You can just plunge attack him and then just come over here. There's two. Just pick one and attack it. The other one will start sprouting his wings, but by the time you get to him, he won't even have finished sprouting his wing animation, I guess. He will just spray poison mist at you. So try to avoid that if possible. And he also shoots fire at you, so avoid that as well. Now come over here, grab this item, and then right there is a barbarian, kind of a throwback to Mildred from Dark Souls 1. And her weapon not or weapon art for that weapon is actually pretty neat. It's basically sharpens it, and every time you land a hit with it, it regens your health a little. But our weapon, and it's also good if you're doing a strength build, at least starting off with it here, because you get it so early. And then we're just going to come down here, get this, I think it was the Brigandier set. Along with the twin blades. And so, oh yeah, with Mildred there, basically just use your sword art, makes it real easy to kill her. I was doing almost close to half damage, when hitting her with it. And then we're just coming up here so we can grab the Titanite shard. So we're gonna head over this way, continuing on. Instead of going on this bridge up here where the enemies are, just come over to the tree, look down, and jump. There's a nice little ledge here, and down here there is actually two dogs, so beware of them. One will try and jump out at you if you try going after that one that you can see. And this one is actually a bigger one. It does have a grab attack, so kind of beware of that. And down here is basically the first Braille tome that you're going to give Irene, and the Mourn's Ring, which increases your miracles. So kill this one and just look down here, and I think we just fireball at this one until he comes closer, and then we're just going to plunge attack on him. He almost jumps up, which would have been really interesting, but oh well. Now these guys are fairly simple. Just take out these guys first, and then you can deal with the one that sprays poison and stuff. A lot of people go for the poison one first, allowing these guys to change, and these guys are actually a pain in the ass whenever you're having to fight them while they're fully formed. Especially if you're having to deal with two or three of them at a time. So we'll grab the ember and head back this or down this way to the bonfire. And we'll also meet our next two NPC players. So Henri there, is the one on the left, and then her friend there in the black who doesn't talk. But if you talk to him, he will give you the covenant for the Blue Sentinels. And so there is a build that you can do. It's a hollowing build. Basically, what you need is her sword and to basically raise your luck by a lot. And you're hollowing. But basically, the way people kill her, or an easy way of killing her to get her sword, is to kill Horus, the dude in the black armor, first. And then what you do is you take her out to where that dude that was shooting out poison mist, and just let him poison her. Or you can, I believe, grab the fire tome here, the pyromancy tome that we're about to grab here has poison mist in it. So you could probably just grab your own poison mist attack and try poisoning her that way as well. If you want to try going that way, but most likely you won't have the pyromancy stats to do it because it does require you to go a lot into luck. Now we're just taking out these enemies coming down this way, and we're going to head this way. Go right here, avoiding the Black Knight guy there, and grab the item up here. Now we're going to shoot a fireball at him to kind of have him aggro at us, and he'll just kind of try running around to come up here and get us. While he's doing that, we're just going to jump down here to grab the few items that are still down here. So we got the twin blades there. I think the other item was twin daggers back there, but and then we get the Farron coal. You can give the coal to Andre the blacksmith, and he will allow, or he will then be able to upgrade your weapons by infusing them into different types. I think it's like poison and something else now. So these Black Knights are, or at least this one's pretty tough for the level you're at. But as long as you're trying to keep out of his range and then roll in behind him while he's attacking, you can generally get a backstab on him. And you definitely want to avoid that attack if all possible, because it will fling you into the air. Think at some point here I try and shield break him, but I don't think it works. I don't think I get close enough. Well, I guess I did try a shield break, but he just didn't have enough health. So that's a shortcut, which we'll be getting to in Fair and Keep, along with that crystal beast there. So we're gonna head out here and we're going to aggro this giant crab. Now these crabs are fairly easy actually. I'm just trying to get them out of that deep water so that I can at least roll. So he's just going to try and shoot this water at me, and he actually tries to do it twice. Just go to the right a little until you stagger him like this, and then it's pretty much game over there for the crab. But he drops a ring, and then if you go over to that tree that he was standing by, he has, I believe it's the Pyromancer set and the first Pyromancy tome. It's the Conjurer set. So as you can see here, I actually get invaded. This place is actually probably easier to do. This is actually an NPC invader, not the invader that it was just showing. The invader that it was showing is just coming up right there behind him, and he's actually going to take him out for me. But this area, if you can, is probably best to do not hollowed or embered. Try to do it not embered because it will save you the trouble of being invaded here. I just show you this one because I don't think the battle was all that long. And I actually win it. I do get invaded again, you'll see here later. But the dude just didn't want to fight, so he basically lets me get the bonfire for Fair and Keep. And then from there, I'm just like, screw it. And I just leave them. So you can see how bad my PvP skills are here. Not the best. But for the weapon that we have here, we do a lot of damage, and you should be able to win out like 75% of the time, depending on how good the other player is, honestly. But overall, with the weapon and everything that we have, it should be pretty simple to win. But we're just going to head out this way, and as you can see, I'm getting invaded again. This one, we actually do the proper thing of bowing to one another, which I didn't do with the last one, but whatever. And he just runs over here and he's just telling me to deal with these enemies, basically. I'm trying to not run into a trap because I don't know what this guy's actually trying to do, and I didn't want to aggro both of those enemies over there to fight me. But if you stay back here long enough, that one that's walking will aggro on you, and you can then fight them both, or fight one on one with that guy and the other one that's standing up there. They will both drop their weapons. This is the Kurt Exile Greatsword, I think. Pretty good weapon. Does have that really nice spin move. I believe a lot of people used to use this for PvP. They may still, but not really sure. But trying to play cautiously because I don't want to get caught in that little spin attack, because it does deal a lot of damage. But luckily, I was able to get a few hits on him finally and take him out. Now, this other one, he has, I think, the Great Club or Giant Club, something like that. Basically, he's just going to run at me, trying to hit me, and I backstab him. Now, he does have miracles, so he will try and heal himself once he gets low enough. So if I was actually to just not be so aggressive right there, he'd probably back up and try to use a miracle, and then I could just take him out that way, but he was already simple enough for me, so I didn't really have to worry about it. Now he's just basically, I don't know what he was trying to do here, but he was just trying to get me to follow him into Farron Keep, and I generally go this way to at least light the bonfire for Farron Keep, but I'm not sure as to what he was wanting me to do out there. I'm assuming he was trying to just trick me into poisoning me, and then thinking that I probably didn't have the items to recover from poison, or he thought the enemies out there were just too strong for me. I'm not really sure. But here I try to get the backstab on him, and then I'm just like, screw it, throw the fireball, and then he just runs from me. So from there, I'm just like, screw him. I'm just going to light this bonfire, head back up. From here, I think I cut it out to once I get up the stairs here. And then there's an item up there, so just pick up the homeward bone. I did see his health bar go down, so I'm not sure what he was doing out there, other than being poisoned. I think he even left. I'm not 100% sure on that. He may have just been sitting out there waiting for me to die over here, which I do die, because I summon the mad Covenant guy up here, NPC dude, and he basically parries me, which if he parries you, you're going to be killed for sure, because we don't have the health to recover from his parry. So down here is the Sage Ring and the Sorcerer's outfit. So you can use the Sage Ring to increase your pyromancy spell speed, which I just throw that on there to kind of help. I mean, the spell's already pretty fast as is, so it doesn't really matter too much. Grab some more green blossom there. There's another item sitting over by the other giant crab in this area, which we'll get to later. And then we're also going to go to the other side here and grab the other items here shortly. But we're going to first take out this crystal lizard. It will give you the crystals gem. Yep. And then we're going to take out the two enemies up here. Watch out for the one with the staff. He does shoot soul spear, and can deal a lot of damage. This is probably one of the most pain in the ass bots because this dude with the shield and then the guy from behind shooting crystals or the soul spear. But once you take him out, just jump down here and grab the Ring of Sacrifice. And then we'll head back up the stairs once more here to go out this broken part and pick up the item out here, which is, it's some shield, I can't think of the name. Gold something, I think. But that should be all the items on this side. Now we're just going to head into the building a little further, and I think we actually go get the sorcerer merchant before we progress any further with grabbing items. Yeah, I typically with the guys with the shield, I just kick them because they love to throw up that shield, and Your sword's gonna probably bounce off because and do minimal damage. So just kick the short or the shield and hit him a few times and it will kill him for sure. So yeah, just accept him, promise him that you'll do it, and he'll head back to the shrine. I believe you have to have at least 10 intellect to get him to come at or to come to you. Otherwise, he will say you're not worthy, basically, and won't come. Now, if you were to go back the other way, you would actually go towards the boss of this area, but we're not done with the area yet. So we're just going to plunge attack on this one, take him out, and then there's another one right over here, which we're just going to heavy attack him first to get him halfway and then finish him off. Grab, I think, an ember, and then the other one is the Estus Shard. Now watch out for these guys jumping down. Those spears, kind of a pain, especially once they get into large groups coming at you like that. But not too bad when they're just one-on-one. Come over here, I think it's another green blossom. No, okay, it's just a soul packet. There's a bonfire straight ahead here. Okay. Think I was debating on going and just grabbing the items first, but so we'll head there, and I think from here we go and grab the items on this side. That dog for some reason aggroed on us, so we're just gonna kill it first. Well, maybe not. Okay, so we're going to take out these two, and then we're going to deal with the stupid purple phantom here. He's something good to fight just because he does give you, I think, a decent amount of souls, but he is a pain in the ass to fight. I think the first time I fought him here, I actually got him really close, but he ended up parrying me at the very end and killing me in one shot. Now, I did get the backstab here. That is a very rare thing to do because he generally, like, auto turns. I was trying to break his shield there. Watch out for this because he does use pyromancies to heal himself. And then he also has three Estus Flasks. So that's one reason he is kind of hard to beat. As well as he does hit like a truck. I don't think you can actually fight him after beating the boss. So make sure that you try and beat him before the boss. Now the best thing you can possibly do is if he does use that pyromancy spell there, is to try and get him away from it. Otherwise, his health's just going to keep regening, and then it's just going to make the battle even harder. As you can see, he actually just tries to run or like walk towards it to heal himself, but I get to him before he can do that. And there's my happiness because it took me, I think, three tries just to beat him, because he parried me on the other two times. Stupid pain in the butt to beat. So, just keep trying at them. Eventually you will get them. Now, we're just coming over here to clear out the items in the area. And once we're done with that, we will. I think we may go back to Firelink Shrine and then take on the boss. But I guess we'll just have to see on that. So, just gonna finish off these guys. And there is a shield up here that we're going to grab. And then there's also, I believe, a Titanite shard over by those mushroom-looking things. Now these guys will spray poison out. So in those large groups like that, beware of it because it will stack on you. As you can see right there, just one almost poisoned me. And once you're done with that, just come up here and there's one more item. And then we gotta go around this ledge as well. And there's another item over there. So we have, I believe, one more item in the area. Just gotta deal with some of these enemies first before I can grab it. Now, you're gonna see here what happens when you get two or three of these guys fighting you at once. They just keep poking at you while you're trying to swing, making it almost impossible for you to swing. That's why I recommend that you try and fight them one at a time. So here you just take these guys out, pretty simple. And as you could see earlier, these guys with the spy or pikes are actually weak to fire as well. They will do that little stagger, kind of like the dogs do. But now we're pretty much done with this area, item wise. We're just gonna head back to the bonfire. Well, actually, we still have one more item, I guess. Because we've got the item by the giant crab that's over here that I have yet to went and go grab, but whenever I come back, I will grab that because I believe right here we're going to travel to the shrine. And then I think we're going to level up some stuff and give some items to some people. This is a new NPC for the area. I think if you join the Rosario's Covenant, it'll basically end, I think, her quest line completely. So that's one reason that we try to avoid joining that covenant. You can grab the medallion, just don't give her a pelt, just don't give Rosario a pelt tongue. If you do that, then you're basically killing that quest line. Now we're going to give him the Pyromancy Tome. And I think level up our glove a little bit because we're noticing now that it is kind of not doing the amount of damage that we want. Which it could also just be because we're using a fireball instead of the fire orb. Fire orb does more damage, and I think it just deal or takes a little more FP. I think it was 14 FP from what I could see there. But I also forget to equip it, but that's okay because I'm not really going to be using pyromancy against this next boss, because he is a spellcaster. So I'm just going to stick to using my sword against him, because it's going to deal way more damage than any kind of spell. So now that we're done here, we're just going to head back. First thing that I'm going to do once I get there is grab the item by the giant crab. I'm pretty sure it's like the crest shield, or it's another shield I know for sure on that, but as to which one it is, I'm not. It's the grass crest shield, something like that. Now watch out for that giant crab too, because he'll probably slam his hand down there while you're grabbing that item. That's why I was trying to roll away, and here I'm just trying to run away from all the enemies and go in here, take out these enemies, kill him so he doesn't aggro the rest of them. There's actually a staff over here, the heretic staff. I guess that's the last item. And now we're just going to kill out these guys, take out this little sorcerer guy here. Because we're tired of him shooting those spells at us. And we're going to head towards the boss now. Now, I believe there is a summoning sign for Egon, I think, so it was, over on the other side. But I've never actually summoned him for this boss. This boss isn't all that difficult, to be honest. It can be a little overwhelming the first time you try it, especially once you get him past that half health point. But you'll see the best way of dealing with him. So what you want to do is just come up here, attack him. He basically will disappear on you once you pretty much use up all your stamina. I don't know if that's how it technically goes, because right here, I was just kind of testing it out, I guess. I was hitting him a few times, and then I would let my stamina regen, and then I would hit him another few times. I actually got him pretty low there. If I wasn't trying to waste my stamina there, I may have actually killed him if he would have stayed. But I guess that's something you guys can all try. But here he actually summons out multiple clones. But they all shoot poison, or I'm sorry, blue spells, where his are purple. So it's really easy to notice which one he is. So I got lucky there because he was in a spot where there was kind of coverage that I could hide behind. But if for some reason you get or he summons up in a spot where there's no coverage, you can go around to all the other ones and just hit them once and it will kill them. And then you can go face the actual boss. Now, because where this was kind of a short area, I'm actually going to head to the Cathedral of the Deep's bonfire, and deal with the lower part of the cathedral. I'll leave the graveyard and the inside of the cathedral for the next episode, but here I'm just going to take out these two crystal lizards. And right here, I'm waiting on that big guy to come actually down here so that I can plunge attack him. As you can see, there's two of them. I believe if you jump down, the other one might aggro as well on you. So best to just sit here and wait. And then the spellcaster guy over there, you can wait to deal with him last. After you kill these guys, and you can actually kill these guys up here. They're not too hard anymore compared to before. Just dodge the attacks and then go at them. I missed them there with the heavy attack. Three hits, it seems, staggers him, so just keep that in mind. And now I'm just going to jump down here and take out this guy. fairly simple, because I think we're just overpowered at this point, for the level that we're at, but we are technically, I guess, at the level cap that we need to be for the area. It's just that this weapon deals massive amounts of damage. So we're gonna head down here to the left, and we're gonna take out this guy. He does have poison darts, or bleed darts, one of them, and then he dual wields these little dagger swords, so watch out for that. It's not too difficult, but once you're done fighting him, there is I think it's ashes here, that you can pick up and give to the handmaiden. If you keep going up here and then go left again, there's a Titanite shard around the corner. And from here, you're just going to go back and then head straight across. We're going to deal with the enemy here in a minute, but we're going to go this way and head up to grab another item, which is another shield. Now, with Henri's quest line, if you save her, she may end up being up here, at the end of her quest line. But the way we're going to do it is we're going to use her for the, I guess, the longer quest line, the Londor quest line. I can't remember what the ending is actually called. But it's the one that you basically get the most items out of. So we're just going to stick with that one. Once you kill him, he always drops that spider shield, so just take him out. And from here, this is probably one of my, well, one of the areas I kind of hate the most, because it's literally just those dogs and archers in this little spot right here. Which can be sort of a pain at times, but for the most part, not too bad. Just try to use the trees as coverage for the archers while you're taking out the dogs, and then run over to the left here to use the cliffside or the little hillside, I guess, as coverage, and then take out this dog if you can ever hit it. There's one more dog, I believe, which I'm just going to try and take out an archer here and take out the other archer because they're the most pain in the butt people. And in the process, I'm going to take out the dog as well. So we're going to come up here, and this is the Cathedral of the Deep area. If you head straight, it'll take you straight to the bonfire, but we're actually going to go get the crystal lizards and stuff, and I'm also going to show you this guy. In this area, there are a few of those guys where they'll just light themselves up and chase after you, and once they get close enough, they'll just jump at you and explode, dealing some pretty decent damage. One actually does do that later on in the next video. Kill these guys. There's actually a Titanite shard right there. Yeah, I really do hate the people with daggers because they will typically do that stupid combo, and I'm usually trying to swing into it. We're just gonna come down here. For some reason, you're gonna get free souls here. I don't know why that always gives me souls right there. I'm not sure what dies. But these guys, you wanna avoid being touched by them or sprayed by them, I guess. Because they will put leeches on you, and those leeches will deal you bleed damage. I believe they do 2 full bars of bleed damage and then half a bar. So it does bleed you for quite a lot, or quite a while. But they are weak to fire, and fire does stun them, so just use that to your advantage. We're going to take out this crystal beast here. Should be pretty easy. You should be able to stagger him after a few hits here and then just go in and critical hit him. And then there are a few crystal lizards down here. That's what we're going to grab now. So we'll get this one, and then there's another one right up here. Around the corner, but we're going to first go up here and grab the Titanite shard. So just keep going, and then once you hit the corner up here, slow down because there's another crystal lizard. Try locking on to him, and then just run and jump, knock him over, and take him out. Head over to that tree. There's a soul packet, I believe, right there. Nope, a titanite shard. Shows you how well I can remember these items. Now just pull out your pyromancy glove and let this guy attack you or try to attack you, and then just fireball him. I think at this point I realized that I forgot my other pyromancy spell, which would have probably came close to maybe one shot in these guys, but whatever. So here's a chime. I've never actually used that one, and from what I can tell, it's not really the greatest to use because I'd never seen anyone's build that had that. Now there's one more enemy, and I think two more items that we get, maybe one more. But yeah, it's just another one of those little slug leech things. So just fireball it, and once you kill it, there's a ring over to the left here. And once we get up to the part where we're going to go to the bonfire, there's one more item on the ledge up here before we jump down. And there's also one more item inside here where the bonfire is, over to the right side. So, got all the items in that little section there. We're gonna light the bonfire here, and that should be everything in this area. I think we're just gonna head back to Firelink Shrine and do a little, Firelink Shrine stuff, talk to the NPCs, level up, all the good stuff. So, I'll just let that play through here. If anything important pops up, I will try and talk about it, but I don't think there's anything really important. Now, I guess one thing I can say is what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to get my intellect, faith, and attunement up to 20, and then I'm going to then start working on vigor and endurance again. Because my endurance and vigor are kind of getting low, at the point where I'm at. But they're still working out for me. If you're having issues with that, you can actually throw some of these points into your vigor and endurance if you want. It doesn't really matter. In the end, we'll have our vigor and endurance up to probably 30-ish. I might stop my endurance at 25 for a while. And then we will concentrate more on our intellect and faith at that point, trying to get them up to maybe 30, 35, and then our attunement as well, probably up to 25, 30-ish. Most likely at that point we'll be towards the end of the game. Or just grinding for souls to level up. Yeah, so here I'm just going around. I'm going to give her the one good tome that we got. If you don't know which one it is, it's just the one from Kareem, where she's from. So just give her that tome, and don't give her the Londor tome. So that actually gives her the majority of her spells that she can sell. And I also grabbed the ring there, just in case I want another attunement slot, which I don't think I'm going to need it at any point in time, because I don't really have many pyromancy spells. I may use it later on, but at this point I don't really need it. I'm just going to show you my soul or my level here. And if you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and subscribe for more content.